win column. So what do you make of the 145-pound division?
To me, it's great to see the movement within the division, just that they're competing again. Like I said before, I think Yair was dealing with either a suspension or just not fighting for a few years. He had some issues, and then Ortega being injured, myself being injured. There was a little bit of holdup and bottleneck and at the top of the division, so it's good to see some movement. And it's great to see.
The final two for me. Can I get your thoughts on both the main event and then the BMF fight between Justin and Max?
The main event and the people's main event?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I'm excited for both. I hope that our fight gets over with soon enough that I can go out back, and I'm hopeful I'll have a chance to just watch it with nobody interrupting me. But, man, I'm really excited about both matchups.
Hey, Calvin, right here. How's it going?
Good, how you doing?
I'm doing well. So, obviously, a lot of time off, and we talked about the injury and all that. Anything in particular you've kind of worked on since we last saw you? Because, obviously, it's not like you're sitting on the couch. Anything you're looking to maybe showcase on Saturday?
Just an updated version of myself. Every time I step in there, I'm always looking to do that. So, nothing new this time around.
Sterling had referenced that you two had trained together when you were amateurs or something like that. What do you remember about that time?
I was basically an amateur. I never fought amateur. I went pro right off the bat. But the time he's referencing, yeah, it was forever ago. And I made a trip out to Cortland, New York, I want to say, and trained with the Bomb Squad guys. It was a cool experience. And it was very brief. And I don't even know if we were really trained together at that moment, but we were in the same gym. And, credit to New England MMA kind of seeing itself at the highest level here at UFC 300 this Saturday.
It's been almost 4 years since your last three-round fight. Is the preparation any different just to, you know, maybe, because again, you got to get it done within three rounds, right?
Yeah, getting going early and being disciplined for 17 minutes.
Any golf in between the last time we saw you compete and after that? Have you been getting in the range at all?
No time for golf with the comeback coming up, but on the back end, I'm really looking forward to the change of pace and getting some rounds in for sure. I can't wait.
And just last one for me, we got a new champ, obviously, Ilya Topuria. I know it's a bit of a ways away, but just, you know, looking at your style and his, two really good strikers, just how excited are you for sort of this new regime at 145?
Yeah, credit to him. He made that fight, look relatively easy, although we all know the level of opponent that the former champ is. So that's credit to Topuria for getting the job done like that. But it's just great to see movement within the division, and I'm excited to go out on Saturday and stake my claim while I belong amongst the top of it.
Calvin, over here. Just a quick one. You're not only one of the world's best at 145, but you're also a CEO and president of a fight promotion, Combat Zone. So for you, how is that balance like, and what's your favorite part about it?
Yeah, thanks for asking. We have a show next month after the fight. And the best thing I can say about that is having a great team around you, man. It's not even just in my personal fighting, but for Combat Zone, if I didn't have a team around me for my personal fighting, I wouldn't be at this level, and I sure as hell wouldn't be able to focus on this as well, having a show next month if I didn't have a great team at Combat Zone. So it's really motivating and reinvigorating when I get to be at the show next month where I made my pro debut, you know, and fought nine times for. It just puts things into perspective, and if it wasn't for the Combat Zone, I wouldn't be in the UFC. It was the only promotion in New Hampshire, longest running in New England, so a lot of the New England greats came out of that company, and I feel a lot of pride in carrying the torch and just providing a stage for the local guys to get the opportunity that I have in front of me now and just show it's possible for the New England guys to get to the next level.
Any names that you think we'll see soon in the UFC?
Definitely. Nick Fiore, big Combat Zone guy. He did get his shot not too long ago. You'll see him back soon. Tom Pagliarulo, he's another up-and-coming guy. These guys have fought main events for us several times back to back. Connor Matthews just, fought a couple weeks ago. He was, he did the looking for a fight with Dana for us at the Encore last year, and it's great to see him get his shot. And Brendan Marat, another kid. You know, it's good to just see these guys who are gracing our octagon and making their opportunity to get to the next level. And I'm just happy to play a small role in that. And it's great to see, man. My coach, manager, Tyson Chartier, talks about it too. It's almost more fulfilling being on that end, making people's dreams or being a small part of their dreams coming true, man. It's a great experience.
Calvin over here. Calvin, I was a really big fan of your skits that you did recently with Tommy Guarino. I love your little Rocky moment at the deli. Can you just talk about being a part of that and, you know, just having some fun and just the comedy side of entertainment?
Yeah, those guys are good shit, man. Shout out to Tommy and Prosciutto Poppy. I love me some Prosciutto, too, after this fight. But those guys, man, they're doing their thing. It was great to be out there, be a part of that. We were promoting a Valentine's Day promo for the upcoming combat show, the past one. And, man, those guys are professional, but funny as hell. And they're only growing, man. It's great to see I like supporting just New England guys just and girls, you know. Just I like to see New England people just rise, man. I like to see the success. I like to get behind it. And, yeah, those guys are a riot.
Do you feel like the Celtics will be able to win it all this year?
I think so, for sure. Man, they got a hell of a team. If not this year, then when, right? Yeah, I'm really excited for the season they have. Hopefully I can catch a game, man. It's just when you get these fights coming up, it's tough to tap in anything else. But on the back end, man, I'm a big fan of New England sports. And even just watching where the UFC's at, you know, people like to think it's a Las Vegas-based company. Right? The headquarters are out here, but its roots are in New England. So great to see just the growth of everything coming from our area, and proud to be a part of it.
Thank you. Calvin, one here in the back to your left.
Yes, sir.
We have a lot of tape on Aljamain. You've been able to see a lot of it. Are you expecting the same Aljamain at 145 pounds or a different one?
I'm expecting the best version of Aljamain that presents itself on Saturday. You know, I don't see him changing things up because I don't think he really has to. It's worked for him well, you know, to get to the point he's at in his career. But I'm sure they'll have things in mind on how to take me out, but I got things in mind for him as well. We'll see who gets theirs off on Saturday night.
Thank you.
Calvin, this is your first three-round fight since UFC 249. So I guess, how was training camp? Like, was it not as, you know, not working on your cardio as much, or were you still a beast in there?
No, I dog it every single camp, man. I push myself harder than anybody can push me. And almost to my detriment, man. Being this experienced at this point in my life, you know, I try to listen to my body and pull back when I can, but that's always the issue. It's never putting in the work. And I always say, if I ever fall short, it's not because I didn't work hard enough.
What's up with the Patriots?
What is it?
What's up with the Patriots?
Next question.